July 28th, Daily Video Bible Reading from the Net Bible, Nehemiah chapter 12 from the Old Testament. These are the priests and Levites who returned with Zerubbabel, son of Shealtiel, and Jeshua, Zeraiah, Jeremiah, Ezra, Amariah, Malik, Hattush, Shechaniah, Rehum, Meremoth, Iddo, Ginnathon, Abijah, Mijamin, Moadiah, Biljah, Shemaiah, Joarib, Jedaiah, Salu, Amok, Hilkiah, and Jedaiah. These were the leaders of the priests and their colleagues in the days of Jeshua. And the Levites, Jeshua, Binui, Kadmiel, Sherebiah, Judah, and Mattaniah, who together with his colleagues was in charge of the songs of thanksgiving. Bakbakiah and Unai, their colleagues, stood opposite them in the services. Jeshua was the father of Joiakim. Joiakim was the father of Eliashib. Eliashib was the father of Joiada. Joiada was the father of Jonathan. And Jonathan was the father of Jaddua. In the days of Joiakim, these were the priests who were leaders of the families, of Seraiah, Meraiah, of Jeremiah, Hananiah, of Ezra, Meshulam, of Amariah, Jehohanan, of Malik, Jonathan, of Shechaniah, Joseph, of Haram, Adna, of Meremoth, Helkai, of Iddo, Zechariah, of Ginnathon, Meshulam, of Abijah, Zichri, of Minimum, and of Moadiah, Piltai, of Bilgah, Shammua, of Shemaiah, Jehonathan, of Joiarib, Mattani, of Jedaiah, Uzai, of Salu, Kalai, of Amok, Eber, of Hilkiah, Hashabiah, of Jedaiah, Nathanael. As for the Levites, in the days of Eliashib, Joiada, Johanan, and Jaddua, the heads of families were recorded, as were the priests during the reign of Darius the Persian. The descendants of Levi were recorded in the Book of the Chronicles as heads of families up to the days of Johanan, son of Eliashib. And the leaders of the Levites were Hashabiah, Sherebiah, Jeshua, son of Kadmiel, and their colleagues, who stood opposite them to offer praise and thanks, one contingent corresponding to the other, as specified by David, the man of God. Mattaniah, Bakbukiah, Obadiah, Meshulam, Talmon, and Akkub were gatekeepers who were guarding the storerooms at the gates. These all served in the days of Joiakim, son of Jeshua, the son of Jozadak, and in the days of Nehemiah the governor, and of Ezra the priestly scribe. At the dedication of the wall of Jerusalem, they sought out the Levites from all the places they lived to bring them to Jerusalem to celebrate the dedication joyfully with songs of thanksgiving and songs accompanied by cymbals, harps, and lyres. The singers were also assembled from the district around Jerusalem and from the settlements of the Netophathites and from Beth Gilgal and from the fields of Geba and Asmaveth. For the singers had built settlements for themselves around Jerusalem. When the priests and Levites had purified themselves, they purified the people, the gates, and the wall. I brought the leaders of Judah up on top of the wall, and I appointed two large choirs to give thanks. One was to proceed on the top of the wall southward toward the Dung Gate. Going after them were Hoshea, half the leaders of Judah, Azariah, Ezra, Meshulam, Judah, Benjamin, Shemaiah, Jeremiah, some of the priests with trumpets, Zechariah, son of Jonathan, the son of Shemaiah, the son of Mattaniah, the son of Micaiah, the son of Zachar, the son of Asaph, and his colleagues, Shemaiah, Azarel, Milalei, Gilalei, Maai, Nathanael, Judah, and Hanani, with musical instruments of David, the man of God. Ezra, the scribe, led them. They went over the fountain gate and continued directly up the steps of the city of David on the ascent to the wall. They passed the house of David and continued on to the water gate toward the east. The second choir was proceeding in the opposite direction. I followed them along with half the people on top of the wall, past the Tower of the Ovens to the broad wall, over the Ephraim Gate, the Jeshana Gate, the Fish Gate, the Tower of Hananel, and the Tower of the Hundred to the Sheep Gate. They stopped at the gate of the guard. Then the two choirs that gave thanks took their stations in the temple of God. I did also along with half the officials with me, and the priest, Eliakim, Maaseiah, Miniamin, Micaiah, Elioenai, Zechariah, and Hananiah with their trumpets, and also Maaseiah, Shemaiah, Eleazar, Uzzi, Jehohanan, Malchijah, Elam, and Ezer. The choir sang loudly under the direction of Jezrahiah, and on that day they offered great sacrifices and rejoiced, for God had given them great joy. The women and children also rejoiced. The rejoicing in Jerusalem could be heard from far away. On that day men were appointed over the storerooms for the contributions, first fruits, and tithes, to gather into them from the fields of the cities the portions prescribed by the law for the priest and the Levites, for the people of Judah took delight in the priests and Levites who were ministering. They performed the service of their God and the service of purification, along with the singers and gatekeepers, according to the commandment of David and his son Solomon. For long ago, in the days of David and Asaph, there had been directors for the singers and for the songs of praise and thanks to God. So in the days of Zerubbabel and in the days of Nehemiah, all Israel was contributing the portions for the singers and gatekeepers according to the daily need. They also set aside the portion for the Levites, and the Levites set aside the portion for the descendants of Aaron. God, I love this vision of these two gigantic choirs with instruments and their voices. Two different sections all culminating together to worship you. And probably my favorite part, not just the fact that they were worshiping you and that everything was being redone correctly, but the fact that it said the rejoicing in Jerusalem could be heard from far away. And I think about our church today, you know, I think about our church a lot when reading and recording the Old Testament, even the New Testament, and how far away we've gotten from what you've called us to do, from what you expect of us. We've made church and religion and even our relationship with you what is comfortable to us, what we need it to be, instead of what you've commanded us to be. I think of every single church I've gone to where there's always been complaints that the music's too loud, or the music's too new, or the music's too old, or some complaint about the worship. And I think, but we're worshiping God. Like, how it sounds or what it sounds like, as long as it's pleasing to Him, there shouldn't be any question about this at all. And I love that the rejoicing could be heard past Jerusalem from far away. And then I think even more about that far away part, that not only should we in the church not be so offended by all of these little things, but I think it goes back to our relationships as well. That you give us amazing people in our life, kind people in our life, sweet people in our life, godly people in our life to help lead us and direct us and guide us. And yet we forget the 99% of the blessings that we should be thankful for. And we find reasons to fuss and whine and complain about that 1%. Let our feelings get hurt over little things, and they escalate into bigger things. So we have a church setting where that happens. We have our personal relationships where that happens. And then we also do that same thing in our relationships with you, where we want things to be our way. We want a relationship with you on our terms. And God, there's nowhere in the Bible that I or anyone else is going to find where you're okay with that. You call us to rejoice. And you call us to rejoice without terms. Just rejoice. You didn't say rejoice only in what you determine as the good times, Janelle. You didn't say rejoice only when things make you happy, Janelle. You said rejoice always. again, I say rejoice, because I know you have to tell us a couple times for us to get it. Rejoice. And yet here we are spiraling down, catching ourselves, paying attention and focusing and putting our energy into things that really, in the big scheme of things, don't matter. And God, today I would ask actually not for the obvious that we stop doing that, because hopefully you're poking us in our heart and getting us to stop doing that. But I would ask that you help us search our hearts to figure out why we're doing that. Why are we so unsettled in our current situation that we have to fuss and poke and get frustrated at things, at church, in our relationships, and with you? Why do we keep coming to you on our terms rather than your terms? God, I ask that you just search our hearts and our minds and our way of living and be really transparent and show us where those things are coming from. I know in my life it comes from selfishness. I'm not saying that's true for everybody, but I know it's true for me. Your verse, John 3:30, you must become greater, I must become less, has to be lived out in my life 24/7. Worship needs to be greater for you, God, not less because I'm annoyed by how loud it is. My relationships need to be thanked and blessed and prayed over because of how amazing you are and how you make them greater. It is only by your power that they are there. They don't need to become less because I want something my way. Our relationship with you needs to be about you and our obedience to you. We need to take a step back on bended knee and lay all of our things, meaning all of our material things, but all of the things of our heart, all the things of our mind, and we need to lay them at your feet and beg you to return them to us in a pure form, in a holy form, in a form that allows us to live the kind of lives that you want us to live. God, allow us today to think of this as we go through our day, that it is not about us. It is not about the music being too loud, or you don't like the preacher that Sunday, or you can't believe that somebody cut you off, or why did they say it that way to me? That was really rude. You ask us and tell us to think of others as better than ourselves. Goes right in line with John 3:30. Think of others as better than ourselves. God, I know at least for me, I need help with the selfishness. I need help with my kingdom that I continue to build rather than your kingdom. God, I ask for your strength with this, because there is no way that I can get out of this mess myself. It is only with you. God, I love you very much. In your son's name I pray. Amen. Thank you.